Ladies and gentlemen, could we come in and find our seats? Thank you. So with that said, let's welcome Rebecca.
Recently, I have had the privilege to join a wonderful global network of pianists and hear from all over the world. That's what global means. Excuse me. We did a concert in New York this weekend, and as part of that, we invited the pianists to come here and do a concert for our church here. And so there will be four of us playing tonight, four pianists. And we kind of do it like an old-fashioned reel, where each of us takes a turn, and we introduce our songs, tell a little story about our songs. But basically, I'm the kind of person that likes to let the music tell the story, because I think words can get in the way. And I know that the rest of the pianists on this platform, we're called Enlightened Piano Radio, because we really believe that there's a much needed there's a void to be filled with really good music that has a lot of faith and a lot of heart and soul. And this is what we bring to our platform. And we had the opportunity to perform at Carnegie Hall, which is amazing. And our fearless leader had the vision to see that, but also to get the music out there so that we can make a difference and change. Because a lot of the music that we hear nowadays is not very uplifting, and some of it is, but not all of it, and that's my passion. I really want to make a really good message for people, and to change how people think, and change their heart, your hearts. So my first song that I'm going to introduce to you is called G.O.D., and I always try to begin my sets with that song, because it ushers in God. And it stands for the goodness one deserves. But also, does anybody know Harry Nilsson, the singer? Can't live if living is without you. Beautiful singer. And he wrote a song called "Good Old Good Old Desk." And it was about he could never really see God in his life. But he could see a good old desk. And his good old desk was always there for him and faithful. And I really feel that that's the way I think about this music. It's something that I can relate to and always go to. It's not a desk, but it is my work and it is my passion. So this is G.O.D. Thank you.
Hey, would you, please check your cell phones and make sure they're off, okay, or on vibrate or something. Tremendous.
We're going to change the format a little bit. Instead of doing one song each, we're going to do a couple songs together. So I will do now a song called We Belong Together. And I know you're all thinking, oh, that's about love. And I met this person, and it was destined to be. We belong together. Star-crossed lovers, you know? And actually, the song was conceived of lyrically about a man in his truck. So they belong together, and I belong to the piano, so you know, we belong together. If you can take it how you want it, but that really was the content of the lyrics, was about a man in his truck. But I'm not singing it, it's all just music today.
So imagine a truck.
Pianist, and we will go with Judson Hurd. He is from Wilmington, South Carolina?
North Carolina.
North Carolina. I don't know my geography very well. He's from North Carolina. He drove all the way up here.
Let's give him a nice warm welcome.
Oh, that was gorgeous, Rebecca. And another applause for her. A little bit about myself. So my name is Judson Hurd, and after the concert and after everybody played, I'd love to talk to each one of you to stop by and say hi. I'm nice, I promise. I've got some CDs and stuff for sale as well. I was a missionary kid. I'm from Georgia originally. I was born there, but I was a missionary kid to Paraguay. Lived there until I was 15 years of age and moved back to the States. And I love music, you know, and it's a big part of my life. So I'm just going to start with a hymn, an original piece called Sacred Spaces. And then he goes into a popular song called Great is the Lord by Michael W. Smith. So I hope you enjoy it. It's on my first album, Sacred Spaces. Getting over it, you know, but I dedicated my performance for her because I love her very much. And this next piece, this last piece I'm going to play, it's called Joy. It's on my newest album. And I wrote it when I found out I was becoming an uncle for the first time. So it was her son, and it's a very happy piece. There's a technique that I call, I learned it in a conservatory, it's called Evocata. Just watch for it, you know? And so anyway, thank you so much for having me, Pastor Rick, and for having me. And feel free to just come by and tell me your name, tell me your story. I met so many people, so many awesome stories this tour. So thank you so much.
This weekend, so I just really appreciate the hearts of musicians to come out and play and give their heart. And Christoph sang a song this morning and just offered that for us, and I just really appreciate the gift of music and everybody sharing it with us at Grace, and we are really blessed. So Christoph, hi from Berlin, Germany.
Thank you so much, Rebecca. Also for organizing this, could come here. She invited us that EPR pianists could come to Saugus, Boston. That's Boston for me, actually. And that's all I saw of Boston up to now. And I'm very grateful to be here today, tonight. Also that I could be in the church service this morning and that I got this spontaneous opportunity to play a song. I decided to do something in English which I couldn't really memorize. I wrote that in 1996. So by now I'm doing basically instrumental stuff in Germany, bar piano. I'm a bar pianist and I'm covering stuff and singing for like the big hotels in Berlin and weddings and events. And this kind of thing I call Piano Dreams. It is a row of CDs and concerts I'm doing all over the place in Germany and also in other countries, but basically in Berlin up to now, and that's supposed to be changing, and that's why I'm with EPR for a while now. They're playing my music, and I'm happy I met many great new people here who are connecting me to other radio stations and all that stuff since we were at Carnegie Hall yesterday. I'm going to play a song now that I called Cosmos Lead, because it is Cosmos Lead. Cosmos, my little son, and that was the first composition of his. He was 2 years old, that's 3 years ago, and I showed him the first 25 notes. In Germany, it's about 6 or 7 notes you need to really compose a song and have the legal rights for it. He did the first 25, I showed to you how he did it.
I was like this. And change downwards. It went and I made for a friend of mine who got an aneurysm. There was
in his head, there was some bleeding there, and he was not able to talk anymore. He could not help himself with anything, walking, washing dishes, anything. And most people gave him up. He was in a nursing home, but his father believed in him, and he organized a lot of rehab, and he got back to life. And that's what you're gonna hear, his old life, the time of big questions, how it's going to be, and getting back to life. Because I was experiencing this miracle of life and of God. So, this is Amelie, and it was written for my son, but not with me. So if you ever want to go that side, there is a sheet book on the brainstorm right there, and also some of the CDs put on that. So thanks so much for listening, and I give the microphone back to Ruben.
Thank you, Christo. That was beautiful.
Nice.
And whew, Amelie. Amelie should have been born after that. That was gorgeous.
Well, maybe one day. One day.
That song, Amelie, was gorgeous. And our final performer for the Enlightened Performance Radio portion of our show is a gentleman that I had the pleasure of meeting in New Orleans. So this is the first place that we played together for our award ceremony down in New Orleans, which is another wild city. His name is Louis Colaiannia. Did I say it correctly? And he comes from Denver, Colorado. Another far distance is my daughter lives in Denver as well. He drove from Colorado, though, which, it's me, yes, let's go. I'm still standing. And we're very happy to have you here, Louis, tonight. I think he's one of our veteran EPR members for, you've been involved for 5 years?
Right.
At its inception, almost. So he's the pro in Enlightened Piano Radio. Let's give it up for Louis.
Well, thank you very much. Gosh, it's wonderful to be here. I have to tell you a quick little story, though. We did the rock, paper, scissor thing to determine the order. And apparently, I'm not very good at that game, because I'm the guy who has to come up after these three world-class pianists just finished up. So if anybody has any tips, talk to me after the show so I can help you with your tips. First song I'd like to do for you is a song that I call Tears for Dad, and it's off my Closer CD. This is a song that I wrote right after my father passed away. And my dad and I were just absolutely best friends in the whole wide world. And when I lost my dad, I did, I think, what any musician would do. I just picked up my instrument and sat at the piano. And the only thing I could think of to do was to play the notes D-A-D, which of course spells dad. And I just played that over and over and over again. And I sort of grieved with the harmonics and how that those notes came to be. And then this is the song that came from it, Tears for Dad. Thank you. come back to Denver with me? I'd like to say thank you to everybody for hosting us here, Pastor Rick, Rebecca for inviting us. What an honor it is to be here, and you guys have been great. I really do appreciate you. I'm going to finish up with a song. It's called Dancing Snowflakes. And the story behind this song, well, I just did my dad's song, right? And I did a concert one time and my mom was sitting in the front row. And my mom's about like this tall, right? Little Italian lady, scares the heck out of me. And after the concert, she comes up to me and she does that friendly little Italian wave kind of thing we do. You know, she comes up to me and she goes, "What? Really? You don't have to be Italian to know your mom shouldn't be doing this to you." So she comes up to me, she goes, "What? I gotta die before you write me a song?" So I'm like, "Okay, Mom, I'll get to work on it." So I start working on a song for my mom, and I get it partially written, and I take it over to her house, and I play it, and I go, "What do you think of that?" And she goes, "Yeah, that's okay. But will you play Dancing Snowflakes for me?" I'm like, "Okay." Well, that went on and on. I mean, two or three times I tried to come up with a song for her. She's like, "Eh, but play Dancing Snowflakes for me." And then suddenly I lost my mom. And so I never did finish the song that she approved. So Dancing Snowflakes kind of became her song. So that's Mom and Dad's song tonight. And thank you guys so much. One more thing. If you don't like this song, you have to take it up with my mom. Thank you.
much.
Thank you, guys.
That was awesome.
Everybody stay.
So, in the spirit of improvisation, I've invited a special guest to come up and sing and transition us into now hearing the word. And Julianne Fitzgerald is a wonderful singer that I have worked with to do breast cancer fundraising events. And she sang a song this year that really, really struck me in my heart. And it made me immediately think about Jesus, first of all, and how much Jesus fulfills our life and our needs. Excuse me. And it just hit me so hard when she sang this song that he's the one we've always been waiting for. And I was just so happy when she agreed to sing the song with me. So I would like to invite Julianne up to sing.
Sure.